Good morning. Welcome to worship here at Living Waters. We're glad to see everyone. Please rise with us in body or spirit as we begin worship with the church's theme song, I guess, Living Water.
There's a river of living water in my soul, in my soul.
The peace of Christ be with you always.
And also with you.
Let us share a sign of that peace. And if you have an announcement, please make your way forward so I know to call on you for the announcements. Mark, you want to go first?
Good morning.
Morning.
Just wanted to say that great turnout yesterday for the property exterior cleanup. I think we counted about 11 people that showed up, so that was a really good turnout. Massive mound has been diminished to a little tiny bit, and we worked till exhaustion, literally. I think we're all tired right now, but it's good to see that everybody's back. I want to give a shout out to John and Joe. They, all year, they go around, they cut the trees down, they massive pile, and then it takes us about 6 hours to chop it with 11 people. So it's a lot of work on those two, and I just want to thank them.
Excellent, and thank you, everyone. And top notch to our property chair, genius scheduling. The weekend, you get an extra hour of sleep to recover. That was next level. let's see. Joel, you have an announcement?
Yes, so this month we're doing something different with the food donation drive. And as a, I designated myself as a non-participant in the Bears, as I am myself a Philadelphia Eagles fan, so I take myself out of the running between the Bears and Packers rivalry. Between normally our collection is on the second Sunday, and if you bring food next Sunday, that's fine. But on November 17th, the Chicago Bears and the Green Bay Packers play against each other. And we want to, with the spirit of that friendly rivalry, sometimes not so friendly, but not, I didn't look at you right when I said that. But
yeah, we'll say.
But as our sign outside said, and I agree with it, Bears and Packers fans do get along here at Living Waters. But on the 17th, we'll have an additional day of food pickup, and we will be designating food into Bears camps and food into Packers camps, and we'll see which team wins. 2 years ago, as I understand, the Packers won. A year ago, last year, the Chicago Bears won the competition. So this year, it's up for grabs. So I think it bears repeating to pack your groceries when you come to the come to church. And help your team fly on the road to victory.
Well done. Well done. Yeah, it's too bad they're not playing today. We could light a candle, remember the Bears season. Oh, well. All right. Scouts, do you have an announcement for us this morning as well? And while they're coming up, I do want to say there will not be a Thursday Bible study this week, as I will be at my mandatory boundaries training for our Senate.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Lucas Melson from Troop 194. I just wanted to let you all know that we are doing greenery sales out by the front door. Deliveries will be here December 1st. And if you want to purchase any, just come see us. Thank you.
Very good. Thank you. And there'll be a, so you head out, there'll be a table to the left. Yeah. Very good. We're very proud to charter the Scouts here at Living Waters. Change for Change is coming to a close, so this is the last Sunday to give to Nami McHenry County. The nominations are open for our next quarter of Change for Change, and that'll be open through Wednesday. I sent that out via Realm, so if you have a local organization you'd like us to give our Change for Change giving to, please send in that nomination. Again, local organization. Okay. I do want us to hold the Nikolich family in our prayers. Greg's mom suffered a stroke this week and is now in hospice. So they are gathered around her at this time, as she's likely to be passing any day. So please keep the Nikolich family in your prayers. There's an election happening. I don't know if you know. Just kidding. Tuesday, we're a voting site. So please don't come here on Tuesday unless you're voting. Please vote. Everyone, please vote. We believe at the ELCA that we participate in the earthly kingdom as long as the heavenly. So please do vote. And if this is your election site, come here. If it is not, don't, because they're going to be giving them the whole building for the whole day. So and there's a lot of rules around election sites. So I appreciate you helping with that. We've done this numerous times, but just want to make sure everyone knew that that's this Tuesday. I don't know how you wouldn't, but just in case, there's an election on Tuesday. Okay. Are there any other announcements before our final two? Well, this is All Saints Sunday. We remember those who have passed into God's eternal care. And during the worship, we'll have a time after the song of the day where we'll have a time for you to come up and light candles. I'll invite you up here. I will be doing the prayer during that time with all the names that you all sent, which is great. It's the most names we've gotten since I've been here, so thank you for sending those. You may come and light a candle in remembrance of a saint, or multiple candles if you wish. The only rule, I'm going to be a good example, the only rule is please at the start grab from the middle. Don't be a Lutheran and grab one from the back, okay? Because we did really good with this last year. We want to avoid people having to reach over open flame to get to the ones in the middle. So let's start by lighting the ones in the middle and working our way out, okay? Then you will, instead of the lighters, because that was difficult, you'll put it up to this or this one, so we can have two going at the same time. Light the candle, gently put it back towards the middle, and that's it. Any questions on candle lighting? Okay. All right. You can tell me after service, Maeve. All right, so I really want to know. All right, but yes, and during that time, I said I'll be doing the prayers, but even after, you know, this is a time of prayerful contemplation, whether you're lighting a candle or not, whether you've sent in your name or not, we're remembering the saints, giving thanks for God's eternal promise of the resurrection. Yeah, and we'll just kind of have that going until it looks like the folks are done or the prayer's done, and that'll be part of the service. So, without further ado, we have it's November, which means it's stewardship talk season. So, I'm going to invite our stewardship speakers, John and Kermit, up for our first week in our new series.
Nobody's headed for the doors yet, John. Good morning, I'm Kermit Swanson, and as Pastor mentioned to you, this we are kicking off our stewardship fall campaign today. It'll be running through the month, and perhaps you saw the Facebook post that Pastor put out there, or maybe Instagram, or if not, I will tell you, about a month or two ago, we were talking in our stewardship team about what we would theme this fall's campaign as, and Larissa Stone came up with the idea. It's like, listen, God is calling. And conveniently, hymn 513 in our hymnal is, Listen, God is Calling, which we will be singing throughout this month, and we'll be introducing it today. So I won't hum it for you now. We'll do it as a band later. So hopefully you saw that. Listen, God is calling. This year, and particularly in November, we're asking everyone to reflect on these words and the song to discern how God is calling you into stewardship. How might he be asking you, challenging you into deeper service in utilization of your talents and in sharing of your treasures, yes, your financial gifts? Today, John and I will be focusing on inviting and calling. There are other aspects that are both in the song that we'll be bringing up each week. Inviting and calling. What is the invitation? How is God calling you? How do we listen? The invitation and the calling may be similar in many ways for a lot of us, or very different, and it's up to each of us to listen and to discern that. So now I'm going to turn it over to John for more on that.
Thank you, Kermit. And yes, we were a week late on our red, so maybe next year. So as Kermit said, yeah, inviting and calling is our theme that we'll be having members of the stewardship committee for the next month or so share different themes based on the verses of the song, which we'll be singing in a bit. But the inviting calling refrain aspect is what Kermit and I are talking about today. So I was doing a little research and came across a couple of interesting Bible verses that talk specifically about inviting and calling. There's many, as you would imagine. I decided to focus on two. In Ephesians, or in Paul's letters to the Ephesians, he wrote that even before the fall of man in the Garden of Eden, God had a plan for the salvation of his people and the restoration of all things. God is always at work, even now, all around us, to carry out that plan. But perhaps the most incomprehensible truth in all of this is that he includes you and me in that very plan, inviting and calling us be a part of it. And in Matthew 28, 19 to 20, commonly known as the Great Commission, Jesus tells all of us, therefore, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you, and surely I am with you always to the very end of the age. And Living Waters, we're doing this, right, in so many different ways. Last week at Trunk or Treat, over 403 people showed up to participate in that event. For Rally Day, yesterday with the property cleanup, making the property beautiful for walks through the woods on the Enchanted Forest. We do it with our monthly mental health series, when we get together to share fellowship and to educate ourselves with watching The Chosen or other activities. Fellowship Friendsgiving coming up, the Cookie Exchange, the annual Holiday Jazz Festival, the Christmas program, the Easter Extravaganza, the Youth Servant Trip, Youth and Adult Bible Education, Crop Walk, Food Pantry, Song Fest, and so many more. In fact, Heidi will be meeting with the chairs after service today to invite them, challenge them to dream other opportunities, and really through extension, all of us to think of ways that we can continue to focus on this great commission. Because even though Jesus was talking to his disciples, the message is indeed for all of us. And of course, these things require time, talents, and treasures. So I'll hand it back over to Kermit to talk a little bit more about the treasure part and how the drive will be going this year. And then some exciting news.
Yes, this is actually the exciting part of this this little show here. No. Last week, Pastor spoke about change on Reformation Sunday. Again, we're a week late with our rep. Well, 2025 will be presenting us with a big change, one I've been waiting for a long, long time. And that is, based on our giving to the mortgage fund and to the building over the years and the balance left on our mortgage itself, we anticipate that by about August or September, we will have gotten to the point where our building savings will match what remains and we will pay off the mortgage. And we'll be done. This represents a wonderful and amazing achievement for us, but also presents us with a tremendous opportunity to grow our ministry. And so this year, and we're still finalizing exactly how the pledge card will look and so on, but we're changing our approach a bit to pledging this year for 2025. We'll still have all the three funds because we will still have the mortgage fund to pay off while we're getting to that point. But we're going to be asking for a total commitment to Living Waters for 2025. And then what portion of that you would direct toward the mortgage fund until the point in when it's paid off. And then here comes the opportunity. Because once that is done, we're asking for that commitment to be sustained through the year and the years going forward, that then you would redirect that portion to the general fund for the remainder of the year and in succeeding years after that. So that'll be the mechanics of this, but we're finally at that point, and then in 2026, there won't be a mortgage fund you need to pledge to. It'll just be toward the ministry. And that's so exciting because now it's time to focus. Well, it always has been, but now it's really time to focus on ministry. So more to come on that. Now the song.
Listen, listen, daughters
calling. Wait, hold on a second.
Listen, God is calling through the word inviting, offering forgiveness, comfort and joy.
Jesus gave his mandate,
save us and set us free.
Listen,
God is calling through the word inviting, offering forgiveness, comfort and joy.
Let none be forgotten
throughout the world.
In the triune name of God,
go. Is calling through the word inviting, offering forgiveness, comfort and joy.
Help us to be faithful,
standing steadfast,
walking in your precepts,
led by your word.
Listen,
God is calling through the word inviting, offering forgiveness, comfort and joy.
Please rise in body or spirit as we continue our worship with the confession and forgiveness. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, our refuge, our delight, our beginning and our end.
Amen.
Let's come in truth before the one who loves us and has freed us from our sin. Eternal One, robed in majesty and mercy, we confess that sin has taken a hold of us, and we are complicit in its power. We are disturbed in spirit, and our hearts cannot rest. Unbind us and set us free. Lead us again to the waters of rebirth, that we may live just and generous lives for the good of your world and the care of our neighbors. Calling in the servant way of Jesus. Amen. These words are trustworthy and true. Christ bore our sins once for all on the cross, swallowing up death forever. For his sake you are forgiven, and God remembers your sin no more. Let your hearts be glad and rejoice in this salvation.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty God, you have taught us in your Son that love fulfills the law. Inspire us to love you with all our hearts, our mind, our soul, and our strength, and teach us how to love our neighbor as ourselves, through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Please be seated.
Good morning. Our first reading is Isaiah chapter 25, verses 6 through 9. You can find this reading on page 568 in the Bible under your chair. On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will make for all peoples a feast of rich food, a feast of well-aged wines, of rich foods filled with marrow, of well-aged wine strained clear. And he will destroy on this mountain the shroud that is cast over all peoples, the sheet that is spread over all nations. He will swallow up death forever. Then the Lord God will wipe away the tears from all faces, and the disgrace of his people he will take away from all the earth. For the Lord has spoken. It will be said on that day, lo, this is our God. We have waited for him so that he might save us. This is the Lord for whom we have waited. Let us be glad and rejoice in his salvation. The second reading is from Revelation chapter 21, verses 1 through 6a. You can find this reading on pages 1007 and 1008 in the Bible under your chair. Then I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth had passed away, and the sea was no more. And I saw the holy city, the new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, see, the home of God is among mortals. He will dwell with them. They will be his peoples, and God himself will be with them. He will wipe away every tear from their eyes. Death will be no more. Mourning and crying and pain will be no more, for the first things have passed away. And the one who was seated on the throne said, see, I am making all things new. Also he said, write this, for these words are trustworthy and true. Then he said to me, it is done. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. To the thirsty, I will give water as a gift from the spring of the water of life. Word of God, word of life. Thanks be to God.
Please rise in body or spirit for the reading of the gospel. The gospel of our Lord according to John, the 11th chapter. This is John 11:32 through 44, and you can find this reading on page 75 in the Bible in the chair in front of you. John 11, 32 through 44. When Mary came where Jesus was and saw him, she knelt at his feet and said to him, "Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died." When Jesus saw her weeping, and the Jews who came with her were also weeping, he was greatly disturbed in spirit and deeply moved. He said, "Where have you laid him?" They said to Jesus, "Lord, come and see." Jesus began to weep. So the Jews said, "See how he loved him." But some of them said, "Could not he who opened the eyes of the blind man have kept this man from dying?" Then Jesus, again greatly disturbed, came to the tomb. It was a cave, and a stone was lying against it. Jesus said, "Take away the stone." Martha, the sister of the dead man, said to him, "Lord, already there is a stench because he has been dead for 4 days." Jesus said to her, "Did I not tell you that if you believed, you would see the glory of God?" So they took away the stone. And Jesus looked upward and said, "Father, I thank you for having heard me. I knew that you always heard me, but I have said this for the sake of the crowd standing here, so that they may believe that you sent me." When he had said this, he cried with a loud voice, "Lazarus, come out!" The dead man came out, his hands and feet bound with strips of cloth and his face wrapped in a cloth. Jesus said to them, "Unbind him and let him go." This is the gospel of the Lord. Please be seated and invite the kids up for the children's message this morning. Good morning. How's it going? Did you have a good Halloween? So Halloween is a holiday we celebrate, right? That we dress up as all kinds of, what do people dress up as this year? Yeah. Okay, cool. Classic, yeah. Yeah, I saw that trunk or treat, yeah. So Hogwarts, very good, classic. And there's this thing, what do we do on Halloween? How do we celebrate this holiday? Trick or treat, go around asking for candy, right? And, today's a holiday in the church, too. It's a little different, but it is similar. It's around Halloween for a reason. Long story. Anyway, we remember those that have died. We give thanks for their lives. We remember them. We give thanks for God, that God's promises are true, that they're with God now in heaven forever. And we like candles, but I thought, you know, if we're going to celebrate this holiday, what kind of holiday is that without candy? Get ready. Everyone be nice. Take. Behold! Okay, everyone take. Share. Please share. Please share. Everyone make sure they get a couple. This is good practice in sharing. Did everyone get some candy? Okay, great. Let us pray. And thank you, because then I'm not going to eat it. All right. Let us pray. Dear God, we thank you for your Son, Jesus Christ, and that your promises are true. Please be with us as we remember the saints who are in your eternal care. In your name we pray. Amen. All right, thanks for coming up this morning. Please do not eat the candy until your parent, guardian, grandparent, whoever's with you, says it's okay to. Thank you. Don't worry, confirmands. There's more where that came from. Yeah, I'll say. On All Saints' Day, we remember those who have died as we cling to the promises of God. Jesus Christ is the Savior of the world. They are God's forever. Richard was united in marriage to Jean for 70 happy years of their lives together. He was employed for 43 years by the railroad company in town. In retirement, he liked to joke that every time the train went by, with the horn, they were saying thank you for his years of service. Richard was a longtime member of his beloved local Lutheran church. He was also an avid deer and duck hunter. You can take the boy out of Wisconsin, but you cannot take Wisconsin out of the boy. Raising and training German short-haired pointers gave him great pleasure. He also enjoyed watching the local high school basketball games, helping the scouts in their campouts, and supporting the kids in their community. Richard was a loving husband, father, grandfather, brother, and uncle who will be deeply missed by his family and friends. On All Saints Day, we remember those who have died as we cling to the promises of God. Jesus Christ is the Savior of the world. They are God's forever. Aldana was a clear-eyed about death. Torn between leaving her children and their children, she was happiest with a well-stocked fridge and family crowded around the dining table, but also torn between joining the love of her life, Victor. They had met at a wedding, danced all night, and had never parted until Victor died from cancer a few years prior, right before their 55th wedding anniversary. They were a romantic, through thick and thin couple, dancing to scratchy records, skimping to pay the mortgage, and cuddling on the sofa. On All Saints Day, we remember those who have died as we cling to the promises of God. Jesus Christ is the Savior of the world, and they are God's forever. Peter busted out of Harvard in 1958, preferring to study Appalachian string band music rather than chemistry his father had wished. To support himself as a time study man, he spent time working at the meatpacking plant in South Boston and recalled riding home after work on the T with huge bolognese tucked under his arms, a benefit of his job. Because he knew how they were made, he would never again eat a hot dog. On All Saints Day, we remember those who have died as we cling to the promises of God. Jesus Christ is the Savior of the world. They are God's forever. Ashley's doctor called after their passing and told us, all people die, but not all people live. And Ashley lived. They packed so much into their 27 years. They traveled, rode horses, chased their dreams, worked in a profession they loved, fell in love, mended a broken heart, and still put one foot in front of the other, battling what they knew from the start was an incurable cancer. They did so with grace, dignity, integrity, and courage. On All Saints Day, we remember those who have died. As we cling to the promises of God, Jesus Christ is the Savior of the world. They are God's forever. To our departed Jose, we love you very much. You will be greatly missed. You are the best husband, father, and grandfather that any person would be happy to have. You will live on through everyone you touched in your life until we meet again, my love. We know that you'll be with us in our hearts and through all of the days of our lives. As Psalm 48:14 states, for this God is our God forever and ever. He will be our guide even into death. On All Saints Day, we remember those who have died as we cling to the promises of God. Jesus Christ is the Savior of the world. They are God's forever. You see, today All Saints Sunday is for us. God has already fulfilled the promises of the Savior. Death has lost its sting. Jesus Christ has won the ultimate victory. Even when the obituary reads, Lord, if you would have been here, my brother would not have died, God's promises are still true. Death has no hold on the Lord of life. Jesus joined the grieving, as Scripture tells us. He was greatly disturbed in spirit and deeply moved. Jesus wept. But even then, God knew that death was not the end. This gospel is a preview of the heaven that is to come, the same one that Revelation promises us today. That moment when our Lord and Savior will meet us at the tomb, crying with a loud voice, Lazarus, come out. Ashley, come out. Jose, come out. Child of God, come out. Indeed, our Savior says to us in the end of all things, "Did I not tell you that if you believed, you would see the glory of God?" Therefore, God doesn't need All Saints Sunday in order to act. Rather, today is a gift for us, a gift to us from God, a gift that invites us to remember those that we have lost, to celebrate them, how they touched our lives, through their love of family, in decades of marriage, around the dinner table, how they live on in our children and grandchildren, in their support of the community, at basketball games, at scouting events, when they packed their precious years of earth on a life on earth to give to others. By the memories of the saints that we share today, including their hobbies and passions and values of celebrating who they were as beloved children of God, we celebrate this day that is a gift to us. Today we lift up the saints in our lives. Their stories are forever a part of our own. We live in a time and culture that avoids speaking on death. This is contrary to the gospel of Jesus Christ, Savior of the world. In our Christian faith, we fully acknowledge there's only one way out of this world, an inevitable and unavoidable death. But at the same time, we dare to proclaim the truth of God, that death is not the final end. Jesus Christ is the Savior of the world. We are God's forever. Today on All Saints Sunday, this day is for us to speak boldly on death. In a society that does not, and ever boldly still on the promise of resurrection fulfilled by Jesus Christ who was crucified, put to death by the very powers of this world, and yet, after 3 days, God cried with a loud voice, "Jesus, come out." Maybe you come today greatly disturbed in spirit or deeply moved. Perhaps this is a day of fond remembrance, offering up prayers of thanks for loved ones being whole again with God forever. Or maybe you come to this All Saints Sunday saying, "Lord, if you had been there, my brother would not have died." Wherever you are, no matter how you feel, this day is for you. Today is the time to remember the ones we have loved whose earthly pilgrimage is over. Today is a day that we cling to God's promises, that even though we do not fully understand God, the world, or God's presence in that world, we trust that in the end God will be faithful as God always has been and keep the promises made to us through the generations of the saints. Today is to believe that we, like everyone else, are sinners. But through God's action, God's love and grace, we are made saints with God forever. Therefore, today we tell the stories boldly of the saints in our lives. In the musical, Hamilton, one of the crescendoing songs, spoiler, I mean it's multiple years old now, but you know, spoiler, one of the crescendoing songs of the whole musical asks, "And when you're gone, who remembers your name? Who keeps your flame? Who tells your story? Who tells your story?" An integral part of our faith is telling the story. An integral part of our faith is telling a story of death. A story of resurrection. A story of divine promises made and kept. Of life lived in the time given to us on earth. And of the grace of Christ shared. Don't let this Sunday pass by as just another Sunday in your life. Tell the stories of the saints in your life. Pass them on to the next generation. They always are and will be part of our story. Don't forget those past chapters of the past, for they linger on forever in our present and in God's future. So that's the final part of All Saints Sunday. Yes, we remember the saints. Yes, we cling to the promises of God. Yes, Jesus Christ is the Savior of the world. We are confident in our faith that those who have died are God's forever. But today is also a stark reminder for us as well. We don't know how much time we each have in this world. Our stories are still being written. And those stories matter deeply, not just to God, but the people in our lives, known and unknown to us. Jesus Christ has set us free to serve the world with our very lives, to make our story one that is loving and supportive of the stories of the next generation of the saints. Do you ever wonder, people of God, what will your obituary say? Do you ever think about who it is who will tell your story? How you have impacted lives that you will be remembered for years and years to come. Our world is quick to say that only lives of true earthly greatness are worth being remembered. But days like today, All Saints Sunday, are a brave proclamation against this narrative. To God, all lives are worth remembering. Every life is precious. We all have the power to share the grace of our Savior. We all can change lives for the better. Your story will be long told after you are gone because of how you love God and how you love neighbor. Just like Richard, Aldana, Peter, Ashley, and Jose, and all those that we remember today, we believe their stories matter deeply because we have been changed for the better by them. And we give thanks that they are now finally at rest in the presence of our loving God. On All Saints, we remember those who have died as we cling to the promises of our God. Jesus Christ is the Savior of the world. We all are God's forever. Amen.
Do. The music director is wrong. Sorry.
I'm a 6'8".
Okay. One, two, three, four, five, six.
Your breath in our lungs, so we pour out our praise, pour out.
This time I invite the congregation to be in a space of prayer, remembrance, and if you wish to come and light candles to remember the saints, now you can come forward. God, on this All Saints Sunday, we come before you remembering all who have passed from this earthly pilgrimage into your eternal care. Today we remember their lives, their faithful witness that impacted our journey of faith, giving thanks that through Jesus Christ the promises of their baptism are now complete. Together we light candles as a sign of hope in times of sorrow. For you, O God, are the guiding beacon of grace in our weary world. To you, our Savior, we lift up the saints who we now pray for aloud, or in the silence of our hearts, or light candles for. Eric. Butch. Craig. Chuck, Sherry, Brett, Earl, Dorothy, Bob, Dick, Frank, Mary, Francisco, Juan, Jacinta, Justino, Sue, Stephen, Bobby, Adam, Charlene, Erica, Stephen, Steve, Rose, Dorothy, Trudy, Joe, Darlene, Bill, Phyllis, Mike, Ken, Melvin, Annette, Alice, Stanley, Marvin, Barbara, Steve, Ken, Dorothy, Jean, Helen, Jean, Linda, Danny, Mike, Bobby, Marie, Art, Anne, Russell, May, Bob, Furman, Mary, Frank, Alice, Manfred, Steve, Barbara, Marvin, Bridget, Lydia, Jose, Rosalina, Angel, Julio, Don, Jean, Lester, Evelyn, John, Chris, Casey, Stella, Roy, David, Nathan, Claire, Sheila, Randall, John, Natalia, Christo, Kevin, Clayton, Roy, Tom, Esperanto, Robert, Dorothea. Thank you for giving us them to love in this life, for securing them eternal life with you. We cling to your promise of the resurrection and look forward to eternal banquets, and we will be united with them once and forevermore. Amen. Please rise in body or spirit and join me in confessing our faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He ascended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended to heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Rooted in God's abundant love for the world, let us pray for our neighbors, the church, and all of creation. O Lord, our God, you sustain your church in every time and place. Inspire preachers and teachers of your word so that we may always proclaim your love to our children and our children's children. Merciful God, you lead us in lands flowing with good gifts. Deepen our connection to the lands we inhabit and share with our fellow creatures, that all may delight and be nourished by the fruits of the earth. Merciful God, you establish statutes and ordinances for the well-being of your people. Guide public officials and leaders whom we will elect this week in a way of love, for there is no commandment or law greater than this. Grant discernment to all voters and safety to election officials. Merciful God, you show us your love in Jesus, our healer. Draw near to us who are ill, hospitalized, or undergoing rehabilitation or treatment. Reveal your love and healing presence through nurses, doctors, aides, and chaplains. This time we lift up prayers out loud in the silence of our hearts, including thanksgiving for the stewardship team, Living Waters ministry teams, encouragement for Ed, healing for Diane and Ron, thanksgiving for family, for Kyra and Nicholas's wedding, grief support for the Bangs family, healing for Betty. Thanksgiving for Pastor Stephanie, Carol, CT, Chris, and Kermit. Grief support for Doris and family. Encouragement for the Nikolich family and Donnie. And all those we name aloud or in the silence of our hearts at home in the comments section at this time. Merciful God, you hold us close all the days of our life. Instill in children and adults alike the desire for learning. Guide the faith formation ministries of this congregation that we are emboldened to share our faith, whether at home or away. Merciful God, you are the God of our ancestors. With thanksgiving, we remember all your saints. Inspire us by their love for you and for their neighbors. Merciful God, we offer our prayers to you, gracious God, trusting in the boundless love for all that you have made, through Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen. Please be seated.
One, two, three, four.
Let us pray. Lord Jesus, our portion and our cup, you offered yourself in love for the world. And in this meal, you nourish us with your life. Fill us with your abundance that we may feed the hungry and welcome the stranger, trusting in your name. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Holy, mighty, and merciful God, heaven and earth are full of your glory. In great love you sent us Jesus, your Son, reached out to heal the sick and suffering, who preached good news to the poor, and who on the cross opened his arms to all. In the night which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks and broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks and gave for all to drink, saying, "This cup is a new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Remembering therefore his death, resurrection, and ascension, we await his coming in glory. Pour out upon us the spirit of your love, O Lord, and unite the wills of all who share this heavenly food, the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, whom with you and the Holy Spirit be all honor and glory, now and forever. Amen. Let us pray the Lord's Prayer together in whichever language we prefer. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial. Deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Behold, God is making all things new. Take your place in the new creation. All are welcome.
saved me. Buried, he carried my sins far away. Rising, he just breathing forever. One day he's coming.
Receive this blessing. The ancient one enthroned, the crucified one now risen, the indwelling one poured out, bless you now and forever. Encourage one another in Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Yeah, by Sunday night, they're all in order, and they're all there. Yeah, and I mean, it pulls them automatically if they're on YouTube or something like that, but for something like Living Waters, then under, I think it's attachments, if you go into the song, well, that just has a sheet music, that doesn't have any recordings, but yeah. Yeah, but the key is that bookmark that I sent you, because otherwise, I mean, Pastor and I both spent a couple weeks like, where is this thing? We had it just last week. So, yeah. Sure, yep, definitely. Yeah, people have found it really helpful for that sort of thing. Yeah. Well, I mean, so I set you up with an account, so I should have sent you an e-vite or something like that. So that should be it. Yeah. I don't know what it looks like from your side, if you can see anyone else, because I can see a list if I go looking for people. Yeah. Oh. I've got.